Pokémon GO, the global phenomena, had arrived on the Play Pokémon competitive circuit. It's a fresh start for trainers looking to prove their Pokémon mastery and embark on a journey to become the first ever Pokémon GO World Champion. So, what does it take to become a champion?
The inaugural season of Pokémon GO debuted in Frankfurt, Germany.
With this being Pokémon GO's first international championship ever, the meta was up in the air. Literally.
A Show 6 Pick 3 meta was still forming, but these trainers' skill sets were already well established. Speedy, you know what these trainers are also impeccable with?
Timing.
There's the swap, and he catches the Earth Power!
Trainers were showing up and showing out, and for many of them, their journey had just begun.
EUIC was a thrilling showcase of just how dynamic Pokémon GO is at the highest level. The atmosphere was electric, and there was a buzz in the air.
Next stop, North America. As we soared across the ocean, we discovered that a brand new meta was developing.
And if you're an off-meta pick, beware!
But if you want to take out a Sableye, you just need to have the right moves. Wigglytuff was not the only new Pokémon in Indianapolis. The meta was unstable, like tectonic plates crashing into each other. On top of the chaos, there were two trainers battling on solid ground.
When all the Pokémon on the battlefield are the same, you must not only rely on the strength of the Pokémon, but on the strength and fortitude within yourself.
To become a Pokémon champion, you must be poised and maintain composure even in the most challenging situations.
King Ivy takes the first regional crown, but more importantly, with the help of Iomero, these finalists have solidified the meta.
The meta landscape has formed. Walrein, Registeel, Sableye, Trevenant, and Medicham seem to be the most popular and impactful Pokémon so far.
The championship series heads northwest of Vancouver. Araquanid emerges from the nearby lakes, and the fire Pokémon rise up to meet the core meta.
These trainers are dialed in.
Of Walrein and energy management.
Oh my goodness! What a match! The twists and turns.
I think he's just showboating at this point. Very, very nice display of mechanics right there.
Talonflame telegraphing a play, but makes it look flawless.
As things heat up in Vancouver, we're reminded that no matter how strong certain Pokemon are, they always have weaknesses. You might just have to get a bit creative.
A tournament ago, Cindy's husband King Ivy helped to create the meta. Now Cindy is poised to disrupt everything.
Cindy's Ninetales erupted on the scene like a volcano. Mount Ember is dormant no more.
We swing back across the country to Milwaukee to see how these Pokémon GO trainers react when the odds are stacked against them.
After sweeping the seniors division, Bird Power decided to take on the masters division. Some trainers have no fear. To them, this is just one more challenge.
It was an extremely impressive debut for Bird Power, but in the end, it came down to just two trainers with the exact same core breaker, Obstagoon.
Doombug would quickly force a bracket reset.
For Rise to Occasion and Doombug 97, their opponent was the final obstacle on the way to victory.
These are the moments where legends are made.
Against all odds, the Milwaukee native Rise to Occasion pulls off the comeback and takes the crown in Milwaukee.
Columbus, Ohio reached capacity as top trainers chased their last opportunity to qualify for Worlds. The North American International Championship was the most stacked and hyped tournament to date.
At this point in the season, the meta was wide open, and you could feel the intensity in every single matchup.
Shadow Nidoqueen greatly increased in prominence, but we also had some Poison-type success that absolutely no one expected.
Day 2 was equally as exciting, with Shadow Beedrill and a gorgeous Golden Lucario both taking their trainers into the top 8.
Creativity wasn't the only thing off the charts in Ohio. Situational awareness was at an all-time high.
As the smoke cleared from the grand final stage, the champion, its Axon, emerged.
At the end of the day, success can boil down to making adjustments and playing with your favorite Pokémon.
London was the beginning of a new era. Trainers from around the globe had arrived in hopes of becoming the first ever Pokémon GO World Champion.
As last chance qualifiers were underway, many talented trainers made a frenzied push to qualify for Worlds.
23EJB and his pristine Pelipper play started out the day on the main stage and ended the day with a ticket to the World Championships.
Meanwhile, Stone Collection sped up the pace as his MVP, Samurott, helped him punch a ticket to Worlds.
This was our first glimpse of how immensely talented these trainers from around the world are. It was not just the diversity among the player base. Almost every single trainer had a unique team composition and strategy.
In the field of worthy competitors, what does it take to become the first ever?
You need to show up and show out at the first ever World Championships.
As the ultimate competition continued, the next generation of talented battlers showcased their skills in the Senior Division Championships.
In order to become a champion, you need poise and composure.
To persevere when the odds are against you.
Make the proper adjustments.
And Dancing Rod is your first ever Pokémon GO World Champion in the Masters Division.
Dancing Rob and Meowedle had everything it took to become champions. The seasons change and so does the landscape. So do you have what it takes to make it to the top?
Season 2 is here. So let's go and find out. Follow along as the journey continues this season of the Pokémon Championship Series.